Hi everyone and welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases, so don't forget to subscribe and follow us to stay up to date, and let's get started. Today I want to talk about two Zirconia crowns that had a de-cementation. They just detached from the sleeve, but the cement stayed on the sleeves. You can see that you don't have any residue of cement. You have the composite material that closes the hole, but the crowns just detached from the sleeves. This happened because, first of all, they're made from Zirconia, and Zirconia is a very problematic material. When you're making crowns from Zirconia, it's very hard to cement Zirconia to something else. It's very hard material to work with, but it's very problematic for the cementation process. So you have different types of bonding, different types of etching that you can make the Zirconia to process it with, but nothing is as good as the PFM with the cementation or different materials with cementation. Now, Zirconia is not as good as all of the other materials. So what we can do to help the Zirconia attach to the sleeves is we're going to cement the Zirconia, first of all. We need to have a clean material, a very clean Zirconia. We need to clean it with alcohol or something for the surface to be clean without any contaminations. Now, this will help with the micro retention, but still we need to have some micro retentions. We need to have some undercuts for the cement to get into and to hold onto the bridge. First of all, to make the surface area bigger, and secondly, this way you can't just remove the crowns. You need to break the cement to remove them. They're not so easily removable. We made a small video that shows how we were making them, and you can see here that this is the Zirconia before the sintering process. And we are taking a very small burr and are making very small undercuts in the part that are inside the crown. It's very important to do this before the sintering process because after the sintering process, the Zirconia is very hard and it's very difficult to make this kind of undercuts in this material itself. So here you can see that we have crossover bridge from the Zirconia 12 units. And in each slot for each sleeve, what we are going to do is we are making small undercuts in the parallel surfaces. So when we attach the sleeves, the cement will get into those undercuts and the sleeves will hold much better with the Zirconia. We recommend this for every Zirconia restoration because with the cement, with undercuts, you have much more surface. The cement holds much better. When you're using sleeves that are not parallel, for example, for the D-type, it's even more important because the unparalleled walls of the sleeves in the Zirconia will make the de-cementation process so much easier, and you want to hold the sleeve inside the Zirconia. So with the undercuts, it's much easier to hold the sleeve inside the Zirconia. You make micro and micro retention in the PFM crown itself. So first of all, the cement will hold much better, but then when you cement a PFM, the cemented glue and the adhesion between the cement and the metal is much better than between the cement and the Zirconia. Before sintering, the Zirconia is softer and you can easily remove it. You can easily polish it and you could do whatever you want. But after the sintering process, the Zirconia is very hard and it's much more difficult after the sintering process. And if you do this after the sintering process, there's a possibility that you've inserted some unwanted forces onto the material because you're heating it a little bit. So before the sintering process, it's much better and much easier. And we don't see any reason why not to do this. Thank you everyone that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you and see you guys next time.